So we have more debug of optimizing to do. I guess first start with the man pages stuff. Because that one is so obvious and it's been sitting there. Been sitting there staring us in the face. So it's this stuff, but I'll take it from somewhere else because this is a bit too, this looks a bit too ugly. Well, that's just a lot more. Again, but still not. This one seems pretty clean. So, fonts. Still a bit early. Reads. Yeah, there's a problem here probably, but I'll just use this where you have user fonts and system fonts. But I'll just keep this use reach fonts. I'm not going to, at this point, see, some of them might actually need to read phone cache and others just phones, and some both. But in our case, that's not the case yet. So, and if at some point someone just wants to read the cache and not the fonts, then we can just add a type attribute here, reads fonts, font cache, and then that'll take care, use that, and that'll take care of that. But I'm having this problem with this set attribute here. See, I'm not the type of guy to be about auditing indiscriminately, but okay, so let's just do this, and if it turns out to be not proper, then we'll fix it. there's still that lag in there. I updated the server yesterday and it improved, but there's still lag. But okay. That's it. .481, that didn't save too much, but some, well, actually did save a lot, almost 9k. So don't be unthankful. Don't be unthankful, that saved you 9k, so that's plenty. I guess at least try it. Not try to install it. This is pretty obviously fine. Let's see if we can find some other stuff where we can save a couple of bits. There's plenty of stuff, but not everything is that common. A password file, but yeah, that's common, but I don't think I can save much there. But yeah, the Stream Connect. System Bus, Stream Connect, oh, not that many are actually doing that. Let's just do it. If not many do it, then let's just do it anyways. Yeah, now this should be fine. So I declare that. Do you have any DBS related stuff? Not really. Connects to system bus and then look for system dbus d. Not this one, but makes me wonder if this is a prelude. Makes me wonder if that's a prelude. Prelude. Actually, this can get even better. I'll do that in the next one because it shouldn't be too much of this stuff. Oops. Well. actually still not bad, pretty many. I'll just copy this over already, but this is, we're going to deal with this. Here we have it. Damn, it's really a lot considering. So this might save some bits. At least some kilobytes actually. Now these potentially probably also connect to the system bus, potentially. Before, where they searching for a light. those are apps communicating with the with system services. It's more than I expected. Oh yeah, this is the only one that's weird. Okay, so next. So what we need to do is we need to add something. This is also part of that deal, the package. And then just basically look for this string here. And then just remove those. To be careful there. that's that. Now we have a similar one for session bus. But let's just save this first and see where we where this gets us. Connects to system NUS. That's not it. Four 7 2, wow, another 9. Oh no. Yeah, 4 7 2. Yeah, another 9K. So we got rid of another 9K by just doing that. So that's really that's what I call optimization. But we got more. We have more. Let's take care of this here. So first is data home, so this is XDD. There's plenty more. So yeah, that's now by default that's only there in local dot local period local is share, but you could have a bin directory there, local bin, but that's not a default, so I'm not going to spoil it. But the reason that I'm saying this is that I'm just basically grouping gconf and dataconf, so local and shared together. And if I would have taken the local bin into account, then I wouldn't have to, then I would have done that separately. Actually, I'm just going to do that separately. But I'm going to try and do this in one run. See, I'm gonna do it like this. If you traverse that home, then you traverse the confine D. It's a fact of life. But I am going to add the conf. Create a actually, I'm not doing that yet because it's not applicable. So, if you want to traverse datum, then you will have to traverse gconfirm. Fact. accounted for in work is. Oh, I'm not gonna get ahead of myself here. break, man. Use your imagination. So I guess that's a no. I saw a bug. This is config home. GLID and Eric Stuffers and config home. Give me a brag. really boring work this, but it has to be done. From one point of view, you could say, okay, but you should have done this the first time around. But if I would have done that, then I wouldn't see those patterns this clearly. Because, or at least I wouldn't be sure that the patterns were as clear as they are now. Now I can't really see the patterns because it's not just one domain trying it. Domains by, that's maybe a bullshit excuse though. The events, use own type of zone. Oh yeah, that's not it. Need to be careful not to get confused. Stay focused. Really boring. But it might save us a couple of bytes, and that's where we do it for. That's the reason why we do it. We're now working on basically some point one version where we have at least some base to build on. But we need to make sure that that as it is at least a little bit proper. And that's why I'm taking all this trouble to deal with this. Yeah, it's stupid boring. If it reads and it's then it's opening it. This is really the job where you don't see much. Well, you see the improvement, especially in the bits that you're losing, but you don't actually get to get to play. So it's kind of unthankful work, this, in a sense. And it, yeah, it takes some kind of attitude to actually take the time to do this. But this whole project takes you need to basically know what you're doing, know where you're going. And know what you do it for, and that'll keep you going. But if you don't, then you'll ask yourself 1,000 times, what the hell am I doing? Is it worth it? And stuff like that. And of course, needless to say, you'll also make mistakes, because a lot of these things I know from experience. I tried it a couple of times before, and I already made my mistakes. And I still make mistakes, but I also learned from a lot of my previous mistakes. So that's just saves me a lot of pain. But sure, we all make mistakes. And that's where I got through it, I guess. pt60. So weird, there's another 6K shaved off. And since this is just barely scratching the surface of the policy, it's just really important to think about your footprint and about efficiency and effectiveness and stuff like that. You really need to think about it, else you end up with a policy module of 10 megabytes or more. And you'll bring your system down to a crawl. And, well, that's probably the case anyways, because, well, like I said, there's just so much to do. Let's just do one more. Then I'll take a break, because I really need to take a break. This probably won't give me much, except some readability. So, cache empty there. doesn't give me much, this probably, but it makes it readable. It's part of the bigger plan. Weird. Oh, it's probably somewhere later. Yeah. Oh, no, it's not. No, I'm not sure. Not less. This is now close again. That was a two. That's weird. I forgot to read the fonts here. So this might actually cost me. It would be interesting to see if this is going to cost me. Here we have an actual case where actually no. The case deconf, I forgot to remove that, or it's a was a duplicate. Weird. It happens, I guess. That's why it's nice that you look it over, that you do it various times, so you can basically correct your mistakes. Okay. So we were at 466, 463. So we have 2K. that. Okay, I'm gonna take a break. But slowly but surely we're getting there. With patience is a virtue. Patience and persistence, which is, you can't rush, you can't just, because you have this feeling, okay, now I'm getting somewhere and you wanna rush, but that's not a good idea. Just take your time and we'll see you later.